In this class, we learn about isometric drawing definition. Isometric drawing is not the 3D drawing. Isometric drawing is a drawing which a layman can understand the component clearly, because many people in the shop floor may not understand the orthographic drawings. So it is just a pictorial view, as you see from a photo, and it should be very clearly understood, but it is not the 3D drawing. These things should be understood before starting the lesson. 3D is having all the properties of a solid, where isometric drawing is just a pictorial drawing to show to an operator in the machine shop or a construction masonry or an electrician who will not be able to read the orthographic drawing properly, and just to give a clear idea of orthographic drawing for many engineers who will not be able to read it clearly. That is how isometric drawing ought to be understood. Here, how we can create an isometric drawing in AutoCAD. I will open the AutoCAD screen and see what we have to do. First, we have to set the plane in the isometric view. An isometric view is a view such that, imagine a cube which is inclined at 40 degrees, and then it is inclined forward by another 30 degrees. So that then you get an isometric cube. That is, you will be able to see three faces of the cube, or any object where you can see the three faces of the object is called isometric cube. Normally we can see in a 2D drawing only two faces if it is a projection drawing. If you can see the three faces, then it becomes an isometric drawing. The object will have totally six faces. So by looking at the three faces, you will be able to understand to some extent the component, or you can visualize the component, how it is, before start producing the component or any other thing from raw material. Now, I will first create an isometric plane. So for that, what you have to do, you have to type here snap, S-N-A-P, command, the command line. Of course, there is the screen also you can select, but easier to type, and hence I have typed a snap. Now here on the screen, there is a specific snap, specify snap spacing, on, off, aspect, legacy, system, type. So here, these are the things shown in the bracket. Now what you do is first style. We have to change orthographic style to isometric style. You just type S, or say S. Then it asks you standard or isometric. Standard is orthographic position, what the screen looks like now. This, and isometric is the drawing where you can make it. Click this. So you get this snap spacing. Spacing you can give, as I have explained to you, snap spacing can give any arbitrary value. Yeah. Okay. Now you see this on the screen, the cursor inclined at oblique as if it is on one face, on the left face. And suppose I can change this cursor position by, that is, change the cursor shape or orientation, you can say, to a different orientation by pressing 5. See, it has become top. This is called top. The cursor looks like this. It is called top. Here the angle is, the angles are 120, 120 and 60, 60. Okay. And if I press once again, you just see it comes to the other face. Orientation will be opposite to the first one. So this is called the right face, and orientation, this is called the left face, and this is called the top face. That means I have explained to you that there is only three faces we can draw in the isometric view, and other faces can be drawn, but it will all be shown as hidden. As far as possible, avoid drawing hidden lines because it gives more confusion. Okay, now we'll start working. Now here also snap with setting, we can snap grid, we can setting, we can go there, click on this, see grid will be snap grid, either grid maybe on, see on, see here the spacing is fine, I can make it. X spacing is not shown because it is in proportional to the Y. It is not equal to Y because it's an isometric view. The length will be, the Y spacing length will be shortened because the component is inclined at 45 degree on one side and 30 degree, nearly 30 degree to forward. So it, there will be an inclination. And so the length grid spacing will be different. Normally, there is a separate scale called isometric scale, which is 80%, 81% of the original scale, original actual drawing scale. Original drawing scale, suppose it is 100, then the isometric scale is 81. So suppose the 100 line is inclined forward and inclined 45 degree, then it becomes 80% of its length, the projection, it becomes the projection in the vertical plane. So this, if you know a little bit of trigonometry, you will understand all these things. For time being, I will not go into detail of its length and other things. Since the isometric drawing is drawn just to understand the part and to visualize the part, so it is not necessary to draw it exactly to the scale and it can be just proportionate. So now I will tell you how we are going to draw the isometric drawing in proportion. So I click snap grid, we can put it on, then you see snap. So here this distance is 5 and this distance is 8.6, something like that. We ready. So either you can have the grid or you can avoid the grid. I will switch off the grid. I don't want the grid. So you can also want, if you want, switch off. And you can want, you can keep it and switch off the grid. And snap is also not on. That movement is continuous for the cursor. Now, so I have told you three faces for isometric view. So now I will draw a simple rectangular, not a simple cube in isometric view. A cube, or you can say, rectangular parallelogram, so any of these things. So as usual, you see, this is the top position. The cursor is in the top position. As you can see, the orientation of the green and orange lines, that is cursor line, is the center, a rectangle, white rectangle, and intersection point is the center. So as usual, you have to click a line, and then you can draw, either you can give a point here, or you can draw arbitrary anywhere on the screen, you can draw it. And length here, we are not giving anything other than the length. No angle will be given. Angle is automatically 30 degree inclination. So I will say it is 600, let us say. You have to 600. Oh, it's not 600, I think it is maybe more. It's too small. This is 600, I think. So we'll draw from here. See, I can say 1000. Click here, and then we can say this is also. This small. The scale becomes very small, so we decrease it. It has become too small. Okay, this is 1000. So we can find the length by. So it is 1000. I will first draw the cube. Here you enter 1000. And once again, we enter thousand, then you join. It appears to be something. Okay, now you can check the point and dimension. Oh, this is 1335, this is wrong. And this also we can check. 1000, this is okay. So we can just draw it. What I just forgot to tell you one more thing, because we are getting an error here because its orientation movement is not correct. So we manually adjust it, so it is not correct. The best way to do is you select the ortho mode. We have selected polar tracking, so the lines will not clearly have an orientation in the isometric view. So better we select the ortho mode. So better always to understand that in isometric, ortho mode is to be selected. Polar mode should be colored, polar tracking mode should be selected in a different situation where you want to draw internal parts. But here, to draw the regular isometric line above boundary, you better to select ortho mode. This is ortho mode. So then the movement of the cursor will be proper. So here you click. So we'll say 1000. And then here, you 1000. And here also, you can say 1000. And then you can join. So now we got to cut because the movement will be ortho. There will not be polar movement, so hence you get correct angles. Now next is, now this top view have drawn for the cube. Now let us see the, it has three faces, top, left, right. So we will press F5 on the keyboard. Its orientation is towards right, this side. So we have to draw this side view. So select here, it moves vertically. So we can say 1500. You can take it and then it moves like this. And top is 1000. This also we can make it 1000. And then we join. Okay. Now this face we have drawn. We have to draw the this face. So what we do, you press F5. So the orientation is towards the left face. So we have to draw it once again. A rectangle. Or in reality it is a parallelogram. So what we do is, we instead of drawing 1000, if you don't, we can draw either 1500 exact figure, you can say, and join here, or you just draw it and trim the line. You can do, I will show you how to do it. What you do is, simply you draw from here, once you, simply you draw, and then this point you draw the other line, ortho line, another. In the isometric, this becomes y-axis, this becomes x-axis. Similarly, this becomes y-axis and this becomes x-axis in the right plane. In the top plane, one is x-axis, another is y-axis. Or we can say vertical line is z-axis and y-axis, this is x-axis. Okay? We can assume like that. And top we are drawing only xy-axis. And the side we are drawing z-axis, and one side is x-axis, and another side it is y-axis. So we can imagine like this also. Or we can say x, y, and here also x, y. Anyway, you can, it is up to you. Better we assume that vertical line is z-axis, right side is x-axis, left side is y-axis. So then it is clear. So now, see, I have just drawn it, and I can trim this. So this is the isometric view. So this is how you draw. Of course, another inside line can be drawn like this. You select like this and then you join them. But it is not necessary, but it is gives more control unless it is very much required, then only you have to branch to show some internal parts. Now, I will show you how we can draw the circle in isometric plane. Okay. Now, for that, what we have to do is you have to ellipse. Here is a, you click on this ellipse, you can type. So you will get, then you can say, see, here we have R center isocircle. So we have to select isocircle. I S O C I R C L E R, just type and then specify the center. You can select any point here on this. I am drawing on the left face, the circle on the left face. Select any point and you just enlarge it. Give a value for this, and that's the circle. Suppose we want to draw a circle on the right face. Then you have to orientation you have to carry out. So FY, the top. Suppose you want to draw a circle with top. You can see once this is top mode, and we have to select the ellipse once again. Once again, I you can select isocircle, and you can select a point somewhere. Either you can get a coordinate point here, a certain coordinate point, and then you can enlarge like that. And similarly, suppose you want to draw a circle on the right face. Click it. Its orientation is towards right face. Once again, click on ellipse. You click enter Y and ask you any point you can select. This is out. So you can visualize the circle is on the face. If you simply draw a circle or an ellipse on the face, you cannot visualize properly. It is a circle lying on the face. For example, I will just show you. Suppose instead of that, simply we draw an ellipse or a circle on this face. See, circle. I will click on this and draw a circle. So you can't visualize it. It will be in some other plane as if it looks. So it's better. We always, when we draw it, we have to orientation, we have to carry out. This is all. So these are the two important aspects of isometric view which I have explained to you. And now in the drawing we may carry out some minor modification. Let us see how we can carry out. This is a circle, that is, this is a hole, we can say. This is one hole, this is one hole, this one. So we can erase this. Now I will erase these things. No, suppose it is a frustum, it is, we have to draw a frustum. What we can do is, you can once again click on the line, select from the top. You have to select a center also for this. What we do is, we select, we join these two things and join these two, and then we can draw from here a vertical line. Okay, now we have to draw another square at the bottom. Okay, this is center of the square. We can, you have to extend. See, I have to do it like this, obviously. And similarly, I can draw another line. This is the center. So we have to be careful in drawing the center line. What we can do is, first we can draw from this as a center line, a square. Top. In orientation, we carry to the top. F1. Length, we will say. say 2000 as well. Just come up here also. We will see at the top we have drawn 1000, we draw 2000. Here also we draw 2000, and then okay, now you trim this, is an extra line that appears, so we can trim it. Oh, this trimming is not required, I think we take time. We can find out the lengths now, because I am not sure whether this is correctly drawn. 2372, 2000. You have to just practice, then only you will be able to draw proper figures. 2000. So this is okay. It appears I have to trim this line also. So this is 2000 square, top one is 1000 square. We want to draw a frustum. What we have to do, the center of the frustum should be lie on the vertical line. Okay, what we find out, the center of the bottom square and bring it to the center here. This center, you bring it here. Now it is concentric. The frustum is concentric. I will erase this thing. This is not unwanted things. For drawing purposes only, we have drawn. Now we have to join them. Just to join them, you will get the frustum. For that orientation is not required. These lines are not seen, so you can as well erase them. This is how we can draw. Okay. Now we'll erase this. Now in the same thing we'll see how we can do dimensioning. See here what we do as usual with the dimension in text, we can dimension, use align, dimension align and dimension the drawing. So what we can do is first how we can align the dimension, that also we'll explain. You use here align, dimension align, click on that. So here either we have to click this like this, first extension, second extension, you can do like this dimension, and similarly you can click here also. Here there is a dimension which we can draw from dimension command or toolbar. There is a dimension toolbar here somewhere here. Now here you can click here, click here, you can anywhere you can dimension. Okay, I will dimension the other side because the front side you may not be able to see properly. So the style, it shows something different because it shows inches and everything. So I will go to the style and erase that things and go to dimension style and remove the unwanted things here. See, it shows alternative units, display alternative units, we are not displaying text. block, symbol, alternate units. It's not dispersing. Okay. Okay. Style, we have selected the proper style. Standard style. See, we can click here alignment. You can see. It shows tolerance. We can remove that. Anyway, for timing, let it be, no problem. Okay, we have damage. And similarly, we can have damage in the bottom one. Where we have taken. Like this. So, we want to align this dimension line with this. For that, what we have to do is, we'll go to dimension toolbar, and there is one oblique command. So oblique, you click this and select this and enter the angle. So it is, how much it is, 150 degree, you check up. It's not 150 degree, it is something different. See here, click here, oblique, select this. The angle is, as you can see, this is 90 and it becomes 30. Or you can actually measure it in case you have a doubt. And you click here and enter the value of 30. So the dimension is aligned. Similarly, at this place also, you can align the dimension. Click, oblique, see, we have to see what is the angle, that is important. It's not 30 degrees. If you measure this angle, it comes to around, if you align this, this angle is 150, it has to be 150 only. So what we do is click on this, click here, enter the value. 150. It is aligned. So this is how we can dimension. Similarly, other one also we can dimension. See, I will first dimension this and then we will align it. Alignment, dimension, align. You have to see, you have to always snap either intersection point and end point. Otherwise, you can't do it properly. You want this. Now you click on this, oblique, select oblique. Now this is in the opposite direction, or you can measure it. It is 30 degree, minus 30 degree. Minus 30 degree. See, it has dimensions. Like this you can dimension. If you want a vertical dimension, you can just straight away. Vertical command you can say, and you can dimension it. See, for example, vertical dimension, you can see from here, you can get it. This is how we can dimension the drawing. Nice of you. Writing a text. What we have to do in isometric view, text is always inclined at 30 degrees and minus 30 degrees. And we have to draw two types of text. One is plus 30 degrees, another one is minus 30 degrees. Okay, I will just show you that. I will erase this drawing and we will make one more drawing to show you how isometric drawings can be made once again. So top. Now I will draw arbitrarily. 2000. 2000. You have just only one value you have to enter. It's John. Jesus top you is John. Bottom you, you have to change the plane. So this comes to the right side. This you can say 5000. And then it moves this way. This is the top we have written, 2000 only will maintain. It's a rectangular, like this. And the other one, you have to define this side, the left face, draw here, like this. And then you can join the point, because you know the point, it automatically moves parallel to the top line, and so it moves directly to the top, this line becomes parallel. So then you can trim command, you can remove the unwanted lines. This is the cube. Suppose we want to provide a taper for this. What we can do is, anyway, so at any point you want to have a taper, click on this, draw this. That is the left face we have given. And right face also, I mean, right face also will be cut like that in the same way. Then you have to orient it to center. Top one, once again press right face to part. Then you have to click on this. You have to always remember to have orientation done every time. Suppose I want to make it a taper. So I want to draw from here a midpoint, let us say, or any thing you can take. Okay. And of course, this line is not required. Can erase it for time, let us see, when it is required. And then you have to make a top face orientation. So on this you draw it, it automatically draws there. And then you take the left face orientation. Left face orientation, click here, click here, click here. Yeah, draw. Now, we have to remove the extra face. This you remove, this, 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 and this face is also need to remove to show a taper. This, this, it's like a wedge-like thing. Yeah, draw. So this is how assumptive to you. You can imagine that there's something like a panel or a wedge, a control panel which has a taper surface, you can imagine it here. Okay? And holes you can provide on this face and this face. I have already told you about isocircle. Now I'll explain in drawing the text. So text command, you know you have text which you have done in the previous class. On this face you want to draw the text. Here, the orientation is 30 degrees. So you have to, this is orient oblique angle for the text. Say, this is, we change it to 30. We'll see whether it is 30 or minus. First we'll change 30. And this you make it a little bit bigger. Now you can type test as it is. It's very small, it appears. Or I will change this to another one. So I will make it say 100. So orientation is that. I will make it 500, still predominant. Save. This orientation. Okay. Click on, of course, the size we can produce. Now the question is, the letters have been oriented properly, but the alignment is not oriented. For that, what we have to do, this line is inclined at 30 to the horizontal, so you can orient that line. Rotate, you say, text you rotate, right? Take here, 30 degrees, rotate. See, now it is oriented. Text is oriented. in the direction. Suppose you want to orient to this, you measure the angle and rotate the texture of this face. Suppose on this face, we can't use the same style, we have to change. Or we have to, suppose we change the style, it becomes minus 30, this will be disturbed. So what we have to do is, we have to create another dimension style. Dimension style. One and set a new dimension. You can set as our new dimension style. You set a new dimension, copy of one. So we say ISO 25 instead of style 1, we call ISO 20 or 30, some arbitrary name. Okay, then we have to set that. Text is standard. We can change the standard style also to new style 1. Okay, you select style 1, close it. We have two styles now. You select this style, and now by layer you select it. 100. Now you can click here. Here once again, type your text. So here orientation is minus. So let us see whether it is minus or something else. We select 12, 100 we select. Say 100. Or we say 140. This style is minus. So it is how it appears, let us see. So it is not inclined in the same way. So we have to change the style. What we do is, you select this and change to, here we can change to 30. It has changed. Oh, now even now it is not inclined. We have to incline further. Suppose you want to draw it on this side, on this line, you have to incline more. On this line, at the bottom, we draw by make it alignment with this. What we can do is, you click what is the angle, you see, 90 degrees, rotate it. It is aligned with this. Aligned with this and inclined with 30 degrees. This is another face also. Here also we can draw a similar text. We have to take a different style because it is a different style. So we have to select another style. Or directly you can take a normal style because it is a horizontal plane. You can take. You can incline this 30 degree, 20, 40, click it, but now you can align it, rotate it, possible you should rotate by minus 30. When you want to edit, the same thing, the edit command, ed edit, you can say, and automatically it can edit it. Similarly, here also if you want to edit, you can edit it. This is about isometric. There is nothing much to discuss on isometric, it has to be practiced, and I am going to close this. You know, brief about how isometric drawing is to be drawn. I will just go once again and sum up. We have defined isometric, and the purpose of isometric is also defined. It is only required for a shop floor person, a layman, to understand the part, what he is going to machine or manufacture or construct in the civil engineering. Creating a, so how we can draw it? By creating isometric plane, sample drawing creation I have shown you, iso circle, how circle is drawn, I have shown you, dimensioning also I have shown you, text edit, isometric, I have shown you in brief. So we have to, you have to practice these things. Now, well, and one more important thing, isometric project only three phases. It should not be construed as a 3D drawing. 2D drawing is totally different. It has 3D properties, it has mass properties, and it has all dimensions required. Normally in isometric, we draw to the actual size of the component, the size of everything. And in actual, it will be about 80% of the actual size of the component. So now I will end the class.